natural spring water is a water for every occasion. On the field of sports, at your workplace, just open the bottle and savor the pure, refreshing taste. Holy Natural Spring Water is produced in Mamakan St. Andrews and is available in all sizes nationwide. To order, telephone 444-7654 or 533-7654. Holy Natural Spring Water, Grenada's purest bottled water.
Caribjet, the award-winning agent, the oldest and most experienced travel company in Grenada. For our corporate and private clients, we carefully choose which airline we book you on. We are the main agents for Virgin Atlantic, British Airways, KLM and Condor, specialists to India, Africa, Middle East and South America. For worldwide flights, contact 439-4444 or caribjet.com.
And welcome to the MTV Evening News for Monday, the 8th of April. The news headlines in association with Quartz Grenada Limited.
Whatever you've been putting off, do it today with a loan of up to $20,000 from Quartz Ready Cash. No collateral needed, flexible payment terms, and fast approval. All you need is your ID, proof of address, job letter, payslip, and two references. Visit your nearest Quartz or Ready Cash location today or apply online at quartz.com. Why wait? Get it done today at Quartz Ready Cash. We are ready when you are.
Conditions apply.
Coming up in the news this evening, Grenadian priest suspended indefinitely. Cabinet establishes cannabis working committee. Total solar eclipse seen across parts of North America. And in sport, Spice Girls shine at Caribbean Youth Netball Championship. We'll have the details to those and other stories. Look to, of course, at the public forecast information. It'll all be right after the break right here on MTV News. Stay with us.
The first segment of the MTV Evening News comes to your compliments, Nexa Credit Union. With you, wherever your road leads.
But when you need someone to help you to your feet, I'll be that beacon to your highest peak. Ooh, I'll be right next to you, no, I will never leave. Come on, take my hands, we got everything we need. Cause you can look to me,
yes, I can.
Whenever you're in need,
yes, you can.
Just call on me and I'll be on my way.
Nexa Credit Union, with you, wherever your road leads.
Good evening, I'm Tony Julian with the details. A Catholic priest has sparked controversy with his bold statements, alleging a lack of action from the Catholic Church in addressing the ongoing crisis in Gaza, which now has him at odds with the Church, leading to his immediate and indefinite suspension from his priestly duties. We have more from Troy Gill.
In a significant development, Catholic priest Father Gerard Paul, who is widely considered a controversial figure within the Catholic community, has been suspended from all priestly ministry, effective immediately and indefinitely. According to a release from Bishop of the Diocese of St. George in Grenada, Clyde Harvey, the grounds for his suspension is based on his apparent attacks on the Catholic Church and its leadership, including claims that the church remains silent while humanitarian crises are unfolding in Gaza. Bishop Harvey made the shocking announcement at the Holy Family RSC Church, River Sally, on Sunday morning at the end of a Mass celebrated by Father Paul.
I have had reason to address the following to the whole diocese. Further to the events of Wednesday, the 27th of March, 2024, in the Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception, and thereafter on various media platforms, Father Gerard Paul has been suspended from all priestly ministry, effective immediately and indefinitely. While the views of Father Paul on the situation in Gaza are shared by many, including myself, his persistent attacks on the Catholic Church and her leadership, as well as his misleading claims that the Church has done nothing in this and other situations, are erroneous and divisive.
Harvey cited that the suspension came after consultation with other clergy members, primarily due to his consistent and controversial statements regarding the Church and its leadership.
After consultation with the senior clergy and some lay leaders, I have suspended Father Paul from priestly ministry indefinitely, effective the 4th of April, 2024. All faculties for ministry granted to him upon ordination as a priest of this diocese are withdrawn. He will no longer be parish priest in the parish of the Holy Family, River Sally. He will not be able to preside at the sacred rites of the Church, that is, masses, funerals, weddings, baptisms, etc. This suspension is not because of what Father Paul said on Wednesday the 27th. This decision has been made because of the persistent pattern of behavior mentioned above, and which he now seeks to justify with no intention to change.
Speaking before his suspension during a recent MTV's community forum, Paul revealed that his statements were made during the Chrism Mass held in March, and he has no regrets nor concerns regarding his future as a Catholic priest.
I spoke at Chrism Mass, but it was at the end of the Mass. All that was left to be done, the distribution of the oils had taken place, and all was left to be done was the final blessing, which is 1 minute, and he had to thank people and so on and so forth. No, I have no regrets, and I will do it again, you know? Yeah. There's a captive audience, and I'm speaking to the Catholic community, and this is a Catholic community gathered. You know, you see, people try to find all sorts of excuses. They talk about my hair, they talk about I'm wearing an earring, and so on. The real issue is Gaza. Yeah. So I'm not about to live, and if it is possible, if it could happen that he could defrock me, what does that mean? That is really anything to be bothered about?
Father Gerard Paul also made waves in August last year as the only priest who actively participated in the Juve festivities. For MTV News, Troy Gill.
Meanwhile, in an attempt to clear the air, Bishop Clyde Harvey released a statement on Monday afternoon divulging that, unlike what is being said on social media, Father Gerard Paul was not suspended because of his utterings on the situation in Gaza.
Father Gerard Paul has been suspended because of his continuing lack of respect for the Church of which he is a priest, and his pronouncements that often stray from the truth. When challenged about that, he does not correct his errors, nor seem to care about such correction. Over the past 10 days, Father Paul has expressed his views in ways that seem to mock authority. Respect for authority is one of the pillars of civilized society.
He further stated the suspension from ministry is not a dismissal from the priesthood.
Suspension, however long it may be, is always with a view to fraternal correction. It is our hope that Father Paul will listen to that call. Our diocese considers him a brother priest, and we are willing to assist him in seeking the necessary help that he needs.
Meanwhile, the Grenadians for Justice for Palestine Committee staged their third protest in solidarity with those affected by the ongoing Israel-Hamas war, which has left over 20,000 people dead and several without food or shelter.
I have never heard the Catholic Church say anything about the situation in Palestine. Not a statement, not a prayer, haven't offered a mass, hasn't done anything. And when little me decides to confront the church, I'm a priest in the Catholic Church, well, you know, all hell break loose. But the hell break loose in the hierarchy, the people are in total support. And that's the differentiation I want to make.
That was Father Gerard Paul speaking on what he sees as the Catholic Church's lack of support for the people of Palestine. He was addressing supporters at Friday's Solidarity March at Montrouge, St. George.
Palestine! Free, free Palestine! Free, free Palestine! Free, free Gaza! Free, free Gaza!
From Grenada to Palestine, all colonizers must die!
Led by the Grenadians for Justice for Palestine Committee, protesters peacefully marched to Comahon Park, repeating chants of freedom and peace in a show of solidarity for the over 20,000 lives lost since the start of the Israel-Hamas war on October 7th, 2023.
When we look at what is happening in Gaza, we think, most of us in Grenada might think that we are far away from it. But to a great extent, we've been through these traumatic experiences.
It's a significant day for us Muslims when it comes to the issue of Palestine, because the founder of the Islamic Revolution, Imam Khomeini, may God's mercy be upon him, he suggested that the last Friday of every holy month of Ramadan, that all of the Muslims, or even those who are not Muslims, once you have some sort of solidarity in your heart towards the oppressed, once you have some feeling towards the oppressed, that you come together on this last Friday, the last Friday of the holy month of Ramadan, and express your solidarity.
This is the third organized protest led by the Grenadians for Justice for Palestine Committee. Trade unionist George Mason presented the solidarity message on behalf of the Grenada Trade Union Council. He says the union is calling for an immediate ceasefire and an end to the violence and senseless atrocities in Gaza.
It is heart-wrenching to see the indiscriminate mass killings of the civilian population in Palestine, of the children, of the babies. Have you seen it? Have you seen it?
Yes.
Children being pulled out of the rubble, their bodies mutilated. The Grenada Trade Union Council says that an immediate cease is long overdue.
Gaza continues to face a humanitarian crisis, and international news agencies are reporting that half of Gaza's population is projected to face catastrophic hunger by mid-July, with 2.2 million people unable to meet their basic food needs. For MTV News, I am Lishel Murray.
In other news this evening, Cabinet has taken the decision to form a new committee to examine the issues surrounding the cannabis industry here in Grenada. We get more in this report.
The Cannabis Working Committee comprises of experts in the cannabis industry, and by September, government will be provided with a report outlining recommendations on the way forward for the cannabis industry. Members of the newly formed committee include Attorney Anselm Clowden, Dr. Sean Charles, ACP Vanny Cohen, and Permanent Secretary within the Ministry of Agriculture, Isaac Bagwan. Minister for Agriculture is Honorable Lennox Andrews.
I went through with them the mandate that was given to them by cabinet, and I received the commitment from all committee members to work with alacrity to have the mandate fulfilled within the time period as prescribed by the cabinet. I therefore have the full confidence that committee will in fact go to work and deliver.
One of the mandates of the Cannabis Working Committee is to develop a comprehensive cannabis policy framework for Grenada. This will be done through thorough data collection. Attorney Anselm Clowden sees the formation of the Working Committee as proof that Grenada is moving speedily towards the decriminalization of cannabis in Grenada.
It is anticipated that we would meet no later than 2 weeks, twice a month if need be, or three times, as regular as is necessary to ensure that this legislation gets through and some relief is brought to those who, for the time being, consume cannabis both recreationally and medicinally.
The committee held its introductory meeting on April 2nd, with the second meeting set for Tuesday, April 9th. Clowden commends Prime Minister Honorable Dickon Mitchell and Honorable Lennox Andrews on this move and asserts that a properly legislated cannabis industry will bring economic benefits to Grenada.
Bring to the country a good source of revenue, both medicinally and recreationally, depending on the quality of the product we market, so that it's an up for Grenada once we get this legislation in place.
The Cannabis Working Committee will play a vital role in gathering data and informing government's policy direction. Over the next 6 months, they will focus on data gathering, policy and legislative recommendations, and industry model selection. For MTV News, I am Lisha Murray.
North America, Mexico, and Canada witness a rare phenomenon of a total solar eclipse on Monday, the first in 7 years. Although Grenadians and islands in the eastern Caribbean south of Guadeloupe could not view the eclipse, Grenada was still used as an observation point for a total solar eclipse some 100 years ago.
On Thursday, 12th August 1886, an expedition party from the Royal Society of London arrived in St. George's, Grenada, led by English scientist and astronomer Norman Lockyer. Their mission was to photograph the total eclipse of the sun on August 29th. There were various stations where the photographs were taken. Fort George, Prickly Point, Hog Island, Green Island, Belange Estate in St. Andrew, and Carrier Coo. British astronomer and seismologist Herbert H. Turner was also a member of the expedition to Grenada. Since then, the island has not witnessed a total solar eclipse. Only two total solar eclipses have been visible from the United States during the 21st century. The first was the total solar eclipse of 2017, which was visible across the country. This was the first time such an event had occurred since 1918, and millions gathered to watch. After the April 8th eclipse, the U.S. would not see another total eclipse for decades, as astronomers predict the next sighting from the United States in August 2044. Total solar eclipses typically happen every 1 to 3 years, somewhere around the globe. But the events are often only visible from Earth's poles or from the middle of the ocean. For MTV News, Kayla Flavany.
That's the first segment of the Evening News Monday. We'll be back with you after the break.
The first segment of the MTV Evening News came to you in association with Nexa Credit Union, with you wherever your road leads.
But when you need someone to help you to your feet, I'll be that beacon to your highest peak. Wherever you are, we'll make your dreams come true. Nexa,
Nexa Credit Union, with you, wherever your road leads.
When a loved one passes on, we all need the comfort, support, and guidance of a trusted friend. You can rely on LaCour Brothers Funeral Home. We provide a personalized professional service that exceeds all expectations. Our dedicated staff responds to your every need with the greatest detail, ensuring affordability with a variety of options. Upgraded state-of-the-art facilities, spacious air-conditioned chapel with live internet streaming, a modern, environmentally safe crematorium, the only of its kind on island, private viewing spaces, large on-site repair center, a modern transportation fleet. Join our burial society today and make personalized arrangements for that final moment. As you prepare to enter your loved one into eternal rest, visit or call LaCour Brothers Funeral Home and select a package that brings added comfort to the entire family. LaCour Brothers Funeral Home and Burial Society, continuing a tradition of excellence.
What does it take to be an amazing woman? Lots of me time. Amazing women are classy, fancy, and a little sassy. It's the drink for me. Cheers. Sometimes you've got to show them who's boss. Alpha male? Nah, alpha females are more amazing. Cheers to securing the bag. We make time for ourselves, for work, friends, and we certainly make time for passion. We're simply amazing. Amazing cream liqueur for the amazing woman in you.
It's time to hit the road again with Grenada Cooperative Bank Limited for the annual Pump It Up Family Fun Walk. Gather your friends, bring out the family, organize your group, come out in your numbers, and pump it up to a healthier lifestyle while supporting a worthy cause. Join us in Karaku on April 14th at 4 p.m. as we pump it up from the Harveydale playing field to the Hillsborough playing field. Then we bring the action to the mainland on April 21st at 4 p.m. from Monrouge playing field to Kirani James Athletic Stadium. It's a fun family affair with lots of prizes and giveaways. Register today because this is the final fundraising push for the re-establishment of the Carlton home. Individual packages are $20, while packages for groups of three or more are $15 each while stocks last. Register online at www.grenadacoopbank.com or at any one of our retail banking units. Visit our website for more details.
Welcome home.
Boyo, they gonna fly with kite now. The wind picking up.
I'm coming. Kaim, what are you doing?
Fly my kite.
Yeah, but not here. You can't fly kite near power lines, boy.
Why not? The wind good.
Because mommy say kite threads conduct electricity.
Yeah, Kai. He's right. If your kite gets stuck in power lines, it can cause power outages, or even worse, it can get shot.
Come, let's go and fly them in the pasture.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Grenlink, energizing our Grenada.
Sunshine Promotions is rolling out the red carpet for all mothers. It's a night of love. Saturday, May 11th at the dazzling Radisson Crown Ballroom. The celebration kicks off at 8 p.m. with the show starting at 9 p.m. Promising a night filled with joy, music, and appreciation. Prepare to be swept off your feet with performances from the legendary Mikey Spice.
I'm born again.
Mikey Spice. The dynamic Lion Paw, the sensational Valine, and the soulful Laura Lisa. It's a lineup that promises an unforgettable night. Get your limited early bird tickets for just $100 EC and ensure you're part of this grand salute to mothers. Tickets available at Giddens Pharmacy in St. George's, Wall Street, Wharf and Grenville, Chucky's Bar, Cass Unisex Boutique, Quick Stop, Pierce Barbershop in Victoria, Calico Shopping Center in Certes, Rena Mills in Karaku, Crown Collection, Health Plus Pharmacy Grenville, Heather's Boutique, and GoToFed.com. Stay connected with Sunshine Promotions on Facebook and Instagram for all details. It's a night of love. Saturday, May 11th at the Radisson Crown Ballroom.
Over the years and presently, customers have been winning exciting prizes.
while ensuring that benefits are realized for all Grenadians by supporting the games of the National Lotteries Authority.
I am Patrick Simmons, former Minister for Sports and National Athletes. The NLA has made significant investment in nation-building activities. Among them are the construction of health, sporting, cultural, educational, and community facilities. Additionally, they continue to provide funding to non-governmental organizations and individuals throughout the Tri-Island State. I support the NLA's mandate because I can see where the money goes.
Playing the games of the NLA guarantees support for sports, culture, and nation building throughout the Tri-Island State of Grenada.
The second segment of MTV News is brought to you in association with Arisa Credit Union. Your financial freedom, your future.
Take charge of your financial journey by switching to an Own Your Own Loan at Arisa Credit Union. Arisa's Own Your Own Loan is as unique as you are because we know one size fits all does not fit you. With Own Your Own Loan, you get unmatched benefits including lower interest rates, flexible repayment options, discounted loan and legal fees, and savings from hardware suppliers. Tailor-made options that put you in control. Switch now and step into the life you were always meant to live with Arisa's Own Your Own Loan. Arisa Credit Union, your financial freedom, your future. Call us today at 440-1759 or visit our website at arisacu.com.
Welcome back. Scores of people gathered in the northern community of River Sally, St. Patrick on Friday. It was all part of the community's annual Saraka. Hundreds were fed and thrilled with cultural and folk performances, as we now see in this report.
The River Sally Saraka comprises of traditional cuisines, cultural and folk dances and drumming, all stemming from and connected to Grenada's African roots. 43 cooks participated this year. Chairperson of Live Sally Organization for Development is Anika Happy Edwards.
Saraka started at the day itself, commenced at 4:30 a.m. this morning with the blowing of the shell to signify and indicate that the day is here and we are seeking God's blessing. We are seeking God's blessing for the day because we want the day to be a day of togetherness, harmony, and peace. Then people went into the breakfast segment, followed by the cooking segment, and this afternoon we have the sharing segment where the people are going to eat and leaves. We start with the children and it rolls out into the adults. After eating and the leaves, we give them a dash of toddy. It's not a full glass, that's why we call it a dash of toddy. It's sweet gospel juice made with a little alcohol, all right, to brush it down. After that, we go into the Tillingo segment. It's a ring game where we play together. As a community, we welcome people to join us and play in this particular game. Then we go into our cultural activity that takes in drumming and dancing, the tambo bambo, the blowing of the shell, all of these things. And then we end with our nation dance.
Here are some highlights of the activities. CEO of the Grenada Cultural Foundation, Livingston Nelson, believes the activity is especially important as the nation, particularly the younger generation, can delve into the country's culture.
Well, a people without a sense of their root is really a people that is, you know, has no place. If imagine you are placed in the middle of the desert, of a desert. You don't know whether to go right, you don't know to go left, because you don't have an idea of where you come from. So to me, that is very important that we do that. Secondly, while this is a tradition, if you look throughout Grenada, everywhere you go, I mean, mostly every place, people show love and community by food, cooking a pot on the drag. All these are semblance of something that, in a sense, identify us as a people. The Saraka epitomize, take that on a greater level to show that this food thing is part of our culture. It is written in our DNA and we're celebrating our identity. So that to me is really saying that this is who we are as a people.
Minister for Culture, Senator Adrian Thomas, was fascinated by the experience, citing that it was his first time experiencing all aspects of the celebrations.
What I've seen at the opening ceremony is fantastic. I think the cultural performances that have been put on is a demonstration of our traditional cultural heritage, and I think the people of River Sally must be commended for the show that they have put on. And most of all, we have 41, 43 food stalls, food vendors will be preparing large pots of food for the people visiting the Saraka to consume. This is fantastic, free of cost. And this is a celebration that we have to encourage, we have to support as a government, and I hope that it continues and the young generation pick up from where the older generation live.
This year's Saraka followed the theme, engaging in community service and development as we educate, elevate, and participate as a people. Reporting for MTV News, I am Akila Aberdeen.
The organizers of this year's River Sally Saraka, meanwhile, are being praised for a well-organized event. MTV News took their cameras around Saraka Village on Friday, where some of the attendees, including government dignitaries, were caught enjoying the festivities.
I think it's a wonderful activity to bring. It brings the community together and so on. Well, we all know the word Saraka derived from, you know, giving thanks to God for his blessings and so on. And I'm happy to see that, you know, the community maintain that cultural tradition over the many years. And this has been growing from strength to strength. Well, we can consider it to be like a national festival.
I should say that I'm so much impressed with what I saw over there, especially when the history of the Saraka was given by the MC. And it offers a lot for information and history, and I think we should pass on those kind of information to children in school.
I'm always happy to be a part of event that brings community together, so I am happy to be part of this activity. It's my first, so it's first time I'm being to this Saraka. I've been to the St. Andrew before, but it's first time I'm being to this one, and so I'm impressed by the level of camaraderie among members of the community and the team spirit and the teamwork. The number of cooks, over 40 something cooks, are involved in this activity here today.
So I would like to congratulate the organizers of this event every year. It is a bumper event. It spreads across the community, and it's really difficult for us to know visit every place that there is food, because obviously with over 40 cooks, it's kind of difficult to get to everybody. But it's always a pleasure being here, and it's always an interesting activity, seeing the camaraderie, seeing the people come out to support what we consider to be an authentic part of our culture, the Saraka, and I'm waiting to taste the food.
Well, of course, many cooks and patrons have labeled this year's Saraka as one of the largest.
For the past year, I find this year is very good. Very good. There are people showing up, and you have more food than last year.
I find this year 2024, this one is about the biggest one. This one is about the most organized one. Last year we had 24 people cooking, 24 households. This year we have 43 households. So anywhere you pass in River Sally today, you could get food. And I find the people real turn out.
I think it's a wonderful year for us this year. And then you could see that the Saraka has grown a lot and continue to grow. I think one of the thing that we have to look forward to is to really getting the young people back into Saraka. So we as the elders must be able to teach them so that they would take it up after.
Yeah, enjoying it. Always enjoy. Once it's Saraka, enjoy it, man. Once it's Saraka, just say Saraka, that is me. You say Saraka, you're talking my language, that's my thing.
With dozens of centenarians already identified, officials anticipate a rise in numbers as more individuals are being urged to come forward, potentially earning them a twofold recognition for having achieved such a significant milestone.
The Ministry of Social and Community Development, Housing and Gender Affairs
is urging family members of centenarians to inform the desk of the elderly so individuals can be officially recorded and recognized in a timely manner. Social worker attached to the desk of the elderly, Lydia Thomas, speaking to MTV News on Monday, says they have been acknowledging those who have achieved this milestone annually. However, oftentimes others are inadvertently left behind.
All the centenarians that we have recorded, we recognize those centenarians. However, we realize that the public, some persons in the public doesn't know that, they don't have the information, and some persons who want to get their centenarians recognized, they don't know who to go to, where to go, or what to do. So that's one of the reasons that we're here, to give persons information on what to do and how they can contact us, and the process of getting the centenarians recognized. We accept a birth paper, a copy of original birth paper, and baptismal paper. You can send that to Ministry of Social and Community Development, Housing and Gender Affairs, or at the desk of the elderly. We are opposite the fish market on Melville Street.
There are over 20 centenarians on record. However, they are convinced this number can increase if individuals are more forthcoming.
We offer tokens of appreciation to our centenarians. And of course, centenarians is persons 100 and over. And once that person is alive, we recognize them every year after that. 101, 102, and so on. Currently, we have 26 centenarians on record. However, we believe that we have more centenarians out there. And as I said, it's because families don't know. They don't know how to, what source to tap into to get the information to us.
Centenarians can also receive recognition from His Majesty, the King of England, resulting in a twofold celebration of this remarkable achievement.
And we would also like to get that information about 2 to 3 months before the actual date of birth. Because to get them recognized by the King, we have to send it normally to the Governor General, and she sends it to the King. And he sends back a personalized birthday card for the centenarian. So we have a twofold celebration. There's recognition comes from England, and there's also local recognition.
Although individuals can opt out from being recognized, she highlighted the importance of having the data, but it also reveals that longevity is possible, even by today's standards, and by extension, promoting a culture of respect and appreciation for the elderly within the community. For MTV News, Troy Gill.
That's the second segment of the news here on MTV. We'll have more after the break. The second segment of MTV News was brought to you in association with Arisa Credit Union. Your financial freedom, your future.
Take charge of your financial journey by switching to an Own Your Own Loan at Arisa Credit Union. Arisa's Own Your Own Loan is as unique as you are, because we know one size fits all does not fit you. With Own Your Own Loan, you get unmatched benefits including lower interest rates, flexible repayment options, discounted loan and legal fees, and savings from hardware suppliers. Tailor-made options that put you in control. Switch now and step into the life you were always meant to live with Arisa's Own Your Own Loan. Arisa Credit Union. Your financial freedom. Your future. Call us today at 440-1759 or visit our website at arisacu.com.
What if you had a choice? A choice of joining a line or a choice of making your purchases online? What would you choose? While you ponder on that, the National Lotteries Authority has provided another purchasing option. All their games are now available online. Yes, Grenadians! From wherever you are, purchase your favorite daily and jackpot-type games using any electronic device. Register on the NLA's website at www.nla.gd. Top up your account and enjoy online lottery gaming at your convenience. We're taking shopping comfort up, 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 several notches. But the choice is yours. Join a line or buy online. NLA, make your dreams come true.
What does it take to be an amazing woman? Lots of me time. Amazing women are classy, fancy, and a little sassy. It's the drink for me. Cheers. Sometimes you've got to show them who's boss. Alpha male? Nah, alpha females are more amazing. Cheers to securing the bag. We make time for ourselves, for work, friends, and we certainly make time for passion. We're simply amazing. Amazing cream liqueur for the amazing woman in you.
It's time to hit the road again with Grenada Cooperative Bank Limited for the annual Pump It Up Family Fun Walk. Gather your friends, bring out the family, organize your group, come out in your numbers, and pump it up to a healthier lifestyle while supporting a worthy cause. Join us in Karaku on April 14th at 4 p.m. as we pump it up from the Harveydale playing field to the Hillsborough playing field. Then we bring the action to the mainland on April 21st at 4 p.m. from Monrouge playing field to Kirani James Athletic Stadium. It's a fun family affair with lots of prizes and giveaways. Register today because this is the final fundraising push for the re-establishment of the Carlton home. Individual packages are $20, while packages for groups of three or more are $15 each while stocks last. Register online at www.grenadacoopbank.com or at any one of our retail banking units. Visit our website for more details.
Welcome home.
Are you looking for a reliable, affordable, and customer-friendly pharmacy? Look no further than Hills and Valley Pharmacy, the nation's leading healthcare products and services provider. We are committed to serving you at convenient locations. Find an extensive and affordable selection of prescription and over-the-counter drugs and medical supplies at Church Street, Hillsborough, Karaku, Jubilee Street, Grenville, St. Andrew, near the bus terminal, and Halifax and Grenville Street, St. George. Our committed team is always available to offer valuable assistance for managing your health and wellness. Discover the additional benefits of our wholesale distribution on Halifax Street and our Medcare Center on Grenville Street, where we provide in-house physiotherapy, massage therapy, doctor consultations, and eye care services. Our commitment is to satisfy all your healthcare needs, including competitive prices, loyalty rewards, and special discounts for seniors. Contact us at 435-6904 and WhatsApp 535-4734. Choose Hills and Valley Pharmacy. Remember, your health is our business.
Welcome back. We now join Clifton James for this evening's regional roundup.
With the regional roundup, I am Clifton James. We begin in Guyana. A 56-year-old Rich Dorzee, West Bank Demerara woman, was brutally murdered on Sunday over an alleged affair by her husband, who later took his own life. Dead is Sarah Bachus Arjun, a saleswoman. The suspect has been identified as Kemraj Arjun, 69. Police headquarters said the incident occurred sometime between 11:30 hours and 15:30 hours at the couple's Rich Dorzee Parfait Harmony House. According to a police report, Arjun's 13-year-old daughter returned home and discovered her lifeless body in a pool of blood inside a bedroom. The teen also found her father gasping for breath on the bed, emitting a strong smell of poison, police headquarters said. He succumbed on Sunday night at the West Demerara Regional Hospital, where he was admitted under guard after ingesting a poisonous substance. Police further said a note implicating Arjun in an alleged affair was found nearby. The note was written on a piece of cardboard, the release said. Over in Trinidad, men and women are selling and trading child rape videos on the social media app Telegram for as much as $200. At least one person involved in the porn ring says 207 videos are available for that price. He's on a Telegram group called Trini's School Leaks Twerks Videos, which had 945 members as of yesterday. The chat is a market for buying and selling child pornographic content. Pornographic content featuring local females, which range from young girls to older women, is also available for purchase on Telegram. In addition, some men are even selling intimate pictures their ex-partners would have sent to the porn groups for money. If interested persons can't afford to pay for content, some men are trading nude photos of women for other nude images. Meanwhile, in other Telegram groups, some people are taking women's photos from their social media pages, altering them via artificial intelligence AI software so that they appear nude, and selling them. Up for sale in the various group chats are digitally altered photos that women initially posted with themselves fully clothed on their social media, which are now nude images. The British Royal Navy says its warship HMS Trent seized drugs with a street value of £16.7 million, $21.1 million, in two separate blows to drug runners in the Caribbean. The Royal Navy said British soldiers, Royal Marines and a US Coast Guard team on HMS Trent intercepted a smuggling speedboat immediately following a port visit to Martinique. The warship launched her fast sea boats, piloted by Royal Marines of 47 Commando, to intercept the speedboat, seize the drugs and detain the crew before darkness fell, said the Royal Navy on Friday. Less than 48 hours later, HMS Trent was back in action, working with a US Coast Guard patrol aircraft to track and intercept other speedboats, it added. Across the two operations, the Royal Navy said the HMS Trent seized 200 kilos of cocaine and other drugs with an estimated street value of £16.7 million. The flexibility shown by my ship's company to move straight from high-level defence engagement activity in Martinique straight into successful boarding operations is a testament to their dedication and professionalism, said commanding officer, Commander Tim Langford, on Friday. The level of cooperation between the Royal Navy, US Coast Guard and other partners has been excellent and has been key to making these seizures possible, he added. You're up to date with the regional roundup. I am Clifton James.
This is the MTV Evening News. We'll be back with you after the break.
Over the years and presently, customers have been winning exciting prizes, while ensuring that benefits are realized for all Grenadians by supporting the games of the National Lotteries Authority.
I am Patrick Simmons, former Minister for Sports and National Athletes. The NLA has made significant investment in nation-building activities. Among them are the construction of health, sporting, cultural, educational, and community facilities. Additionally, they continue to provide funding to non-governmental organizations and individuals throughout the Tri-Island State. I support the NLA's mandate because I can see where the money goes.
Playing the games of the NLA guarantees support for sports, culture, and nation building throughout the Tri-Island State of Grenada.
Grenlec Community Partnership Initiative.
On behalf of the Grenada Athletic Association, we want to thank Grenlec for the presentation of their check. This is not the first time that they are supporting our character games. I can remember clearly in 2016, they were part of the celebration. You know that Grenlec has always supported us in all of our activities, in our development programs. They have been there with us, and we are very thankful for that, and we sincerely hope that we'll be able to keep them as one of our sponsors.
Greenneck, energizing our community.
Keeping up with the kids' growth spurts might mean it's time for a bigger fridge. Don't worry, at Quartz, we got you. Or maybe you're ready to turn your home entertainment up a notch? That means a larger TV and soundbar? We got you. Excited about making your new home feel more like you? We've got you. Need a better mattress for more restful sleep? We've got the size and comfort that's right for you. So shop today and pay later. Whatever you need, we've got you. Quartz, bringing value home.
Sunshine Promotions is rolling out the red carpet for all mothers. It's a night of love. Saturday, May 11th at the dazzling Radisson Crown Ballroom. The celebration kicks off at 8 p.m. with the show starting at 9 p.m. Promising a night filled with joy, music, and appreciation. Prepare to be swept off your feet with performances from the legendary Mikey Spice.
When born again. Mikey Spice.
The dynamic Lion Paw, the sensational Valine, and the soulful Laura Lisa. It's a lineup that promises an unforgettable night. Get your limited early bird tickets for just $100 EC and ensure you're part of this grand salute to mothers. Tickets available at Giddens Pharmacy in St. George's, Wall Street, Wharf and Grenville, Chucky's Bar, Cass Unisex Boutique, Quick Stop, Pierce Barbershop in Victoria, Calico Shopping Center in Satez, Rena Mills in Carrickoo, Crown Collection, Plus Pharmacy Grenville, Heather's Boutique, and gotofred.com. Stay connected with Sunshine Promotions on Facebook and Instagram for all details. It's a night of love. Saturday, May 11th at the Radisson Crown Ballroom. Mark your calendars, football fanatics. The GFA is turning 100 this year, and we're ready to celebrate. It's GFA's Legends Weekend, a three-day extravaganza. Kicking off on Friday, May 3rd, and running all the way till Sunday, May 5th. Witness history in the making. The Caribbean taking on the world in a clash of legendary international footballers on Sunday, May 5th at the electrifying Kirani James Athletic Stadium. Get ready to roar with the crowd as iconic legends like Emmanuel Adebayo, El Hadj Diouf, Alex Song, Michael Essien, Luis El Matador Hernandez, Shaka Hislop, Asamoah Gyan, Ricardo B.B. Gardner, Russell Latapy, Shallery Joseph, Jason Roberts, Dexter Dapps, and a whole host of superstars light up the pitch. From breathtaking goals to unforgettable memories, GFA's Legends Weekend promises an epic celebration of football you won't want to miss. Keep your eyes peeled on GFA's social media for the full squad reveal. GFA's Legend Weekend. Be there.
Spice Girls shine at the Caribbean Youth Netball Championship. That highlight and more coming up in our sporting segment.
The MTV Evening Sports is brought to you in association with Quartz, bringing value home.
Whatever you've been putting off, do it today with a loan of up to $20,000 from Quartz Ready Cash. No collateral needed, flexible payment terms, and fast approval. All you need is your ID, proof of address, job letter, payslip, and two references. Visit your nearest Quartz or Ready Cash location today or apply online at Quartz.com. Why wait? Get it done today at Quartz Ready Cash. We are ready when you are.
Conditions apply.
A special evening to you, sporting fans. We now have your highlights.
Good evening, sporting fans. We begin this evening's sporting highlights with some netball action from the Inter-Caribbean Jean Pair Youth Netball Championship being held in St. Lucia. The Spice Girls left the island last Wednesday and defeated host St. Lucia in their first game on Thursday, 22-18. They faced Barbados in their second encounter on Friday, April 5th, where they lost 33-23. In the third game against Dominica, the Spice Girls claimed victory 25-22. The fourth game was against St. Vincent on Saturday, April 6th, with Grenada winning convincingly 30-15. For round two of the tournament, Grenada came up against against St. Vincent on Sunday. In an exciting match, Grenada stamped their authority for the fourth and final quarter, running away with the game 30-24. There were outstanding performances from local netballers Kezia Matherin, Rishana Francis, Shadi Harper, Antonia George, Rishana Francis, Khadija Norrie, and Carniel Francis. Grenada faces Barbados in two finals on Tuesday, April 9th at 6:45 p.m. The Spice Girls are scheduled to return home on Wednesday at 4:55 p.m. The Grenada Football Association, GFA, recently hosted an intensive four-day referee development workshop at their secretariat in collaboration with Mexico FA, supported by FIFA and CONCACAF. Over 30 referees completed the workshop, which was conducted by FIFA referee instructor Peter Prendergast. The workshop provided crucial training and development for referees in Grenada, Carriacou, and Petite Martinique. Participants gained valuable insights and skills to improve their refereeing and advance their careers. A major highlight was the turnout of female referees.
I am elated to see where we started and where we are today. It's interesting to see that with a little bit of effort, and that was made by the Football Federation to have this workshop, and the involvement of the women that came to the program also. It was very encouraging, and the participation gets an 8 out of 10.
Two coaches shared their experiences about the workshop.
My name is Amelia Bob, and I would just say that this workshop was very enjoyable and very informative, and it just expanded my knowledge on the sport and increased my interest in this aspect of the sport.
My name is Mr. Imran George, and I'm one of the referees from the Sisal Carico. Along with me this time is Dick Wanals and Kenny Newell, new referees. This course, it was quite interesting. I came on many other courses before, but this one, since this one is a beginner's course, you know, you see things a little bit different.
There will be a follow-up two-day workshop conducted by Mexico Football Association on April 17th and 18th, which will build up on the curriculum of the first workshop with a special emphasis on techniques from top Mexican referees. Attendees will gain further insights into the Mexican style of officiating and analysis. The Mount Ridge Sports Club launched its annual Chester David football competition on Sunday at the Mount Ridge playing field. After the opening ceremony, a 5-vs-5 match was played as an exhibition match with the Mount Ridge under 15 boys, followed by the first match between Spice Mobile Idlers FC and North Stars 1-0 in favor of Spice Mobile Idlers. President of the Grenada Football Association is Marlon Green.
This is much more than football. This is community building, and the GFA is always going to be in support of Mount Ridge, football, and the community of Mount Ridge. We're going to provide whatever support is needed to ensure that the community continues to grow and build. And we look forward to some of the young players coming on to our national teams, our youth national teams, and our senior national teams.
Also sharing some words is president of the Mount Ridge Football Club, Chester David.
We want the support from the entire community. We want to assure you that we need your support. We want to ask all the parents and to be a support in whatever we do in the community. We want to ask all the spectators to, keep it clean, and we're going to be able to have a nice time and a wonderful competition.
That's all in this evening's sports. I am Akil Aberdeen.
And with the latest sporting highlights here, we still have to come the public forecast information and then a recap of the main stories.
The MTV Evening Sports was brought to you in association with Quartz, bringing value home.
TV Weather Report comes to you in association with Grenlec, energizing our Grenada.
Boyo, they gonna fly with kite now. The wind picking up.
I'm coming. Kaim, what you doing?
Fly my kite.
Yeah, but not here. You can't fly kite near power lines, boy.
Why not? The wind good.
Because mommy say, kite threads conduct electricity.
Grenlec, energizing our Grenada.
Good Monday evening, viewers. Back once again with the weather forecast and meteorologist Wayne Williams. Sunny and hot conditions again throughout the central and the southern Caribbean today as dry air continues to dominate the area. We are monitoring a surface trough front actually that is moving, that has moved into the northern Caribbean. It is weakening as it does so, but we do expect some of that cloudiness to affect the central islands. Maybe even here in the far south, we may see one or two showers in the next about 48 hours. Slight haze much further back. We're enjoying lovely clear skies at the moment. This haze is dissipating, but some of it is still tracking slowly to the west. Not much moisture around. We can see some of the cloudiness with that surface trough there already bringing some showers over the northern islands, but dry conditions are dominating in the extreme southern Caribbean. The forecast for Monday night, clear and windy, easterly winds 10 to 20 miles per hour, minimum temperature of around 24. The moon set early on at 6:23. It's going to rise tomorrow morning at 6:32. Mostly sunny skies are in the forecast for Tuesday with easterly winds between 12 and 24 miles per hour. Moderate seas, 4 to 5 foot waves, sunrise is 5:58, sunset 6:18. It's going to be a bit hot. The temperature will max out at 31, it will feel like 38, the UV index will be high. Mostly sunny skies throughout the Eastern Caribbean, Port of Spain, Bridgetown and Kingston. Partly cloudy conditions in both Miami and New York and cloudy in London. Coming back at home, the trough over the northern Caribbean could possibly bring us some very brief showers on mostly on Wednesday. There is a 50% chance that you may see one or two on Thursday, but those showers, if they materialize, will interrupt mostly fair conditions. A slight increase in cloudiness at that time also, but from Friday and into the weekend, lots more sunshine will return. Temperatures are going to remain around 31. It's going to feel a bit warm in the daytime. The UV index will be high. That is it for me for Monday night, folks. Have yourself a great night. Join me again on Tuesday.
MTV Weather Report was brought to you in association with Grenlec, energizing our Grenada.
And now to end the news, a recap of the headlines. A Grenadian priest has been suspended indefinitely. Cabinet has established a cannabis working committee. Total solar eclipse was seen across parts of North America. And in sport, Spice Girls shone at the Caribbean Youth Netball Championship. We've had details to those and other stories, a look to at the public forecast information. So now, on behalf of the news and production departments, I'm Tony Julian. We all thank you for viewing and wish you a good night.
Agnes Marilyn Young, also known as Auntie Marilyn and Maru, of Duquesne, who resided at Nonpareil St. Mark, passed away on Monday, March 4th, 2024 in the USA at the age of 77. She was the mother of Anthony Bison Young, Leroy, Mathlin, Matthew, Valo and Lynn. Grandmother of 15 including Lester, Ron, Dwight, Jada, Sihada Lordells, Troydy, Troydell, Troy, Lidon and Lyndon. Great-grandmother of Leah, Emron, Carmelo, Lisel, Amara and Sky. Grand-aunt of 54 including Eslin, Dinah, Leno, Margaret, Rhonda, Anne-Marie, Servant, Kenneth, Peter, Elimus Gilbert, also known as Pecky, and Marvin. Great-grandaunt of 54, mother-in-law of Mary Charles, Annie and Junior. Many cousins, other relatives and close friends, including the Young and Peters families of Moya, Pastor Raphael Jones, members of the Duquesne Bible Holiness Church, Shanda, Chrisanne, Monica, Elsa, members of the Open Bible Church, George Esme and family, members of the Duquesne Roman Catholic Church, and friends and neighbors of Duquesne, Nonpareil and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Agnes Marilyn Young, also known as Auntie Marilyn and Maru, of Duquesne, who resided at Nonpareil St. Mark, will take place on Tuesday, April 9th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Duquesne Holiness Church, and entombment will be at the Marley Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Elisha Joseph, also known as Diddy, of Hope St. Andrew, who resided in England, passed away on Sunday, March 3rd, 2024 in England at the age of 87. He was the father of Joel, Mavis and Myrtle, father-in-law of Anthony, stepfather of Patsy, Becton, Yvonne, Elaine, Carlton, Sharon and Louisa, also known as Micey, and their families, grandfather of Joshina, Jada and Jayonsi, great-grandfather of Azari, brother of Isaac, John, Samson, and Samuel and their families. Other relatives and close friends in Trinidad, Canada, the United Kingdom, and Grenada, including the Francis family of Roucaine, the Wellington, Japal, and Peters families, and friends and relatives of Hope City, Host Royal, and Marquis St. Andrew. The funeral of the late Elisha Joseph, also known as Diddy, of Hope St. Andrew, who resided in England, will take place on Tuesday, April 9th in London, England. A memorial service will be held in Grenada at a later date. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Muriel Emily Bell, née Baptiste, also known as Tanti, of Tuileries St. Andrew, who resided at Woburn St. George, a well-known shopkeeper and seamstress, passed away on Saturday, 23rd March 2024, at the age of 79. She was the mother of Dale Rodney Bell, Miranda and Raul Bell, grandmother of Rahanna Bell Jerome, Ashwina, Therese, Tamia, Khadija, Aisha, Alistair and Sierra Bell, great-grandmother of Tristan, Carter and Miles Jerome, sister of Rita Sidney, Cecilia Henry, Joanne David, Carmen Bubb, Dessa Mason, Egbert and Anselm Baptiste, mother-in-law of Chelsea Martin and Oslyn Bell, grandmother-in-law of Malcolm Jerome, nieces and nephews John, Glenn, Orlando, Francis and Michael Sidney, Dennis and Sybil Henry, Risa, Al and Alec Mason, Geraldine Frederick, Lucy, Lorna, Mike, Kenneth, Derek, Avril, Maureen, Martin, Kester, Daron, Mia, David and Eleanor. Other relatives and friends including Janice Hercules, Alana Samuel, Paula Lessie, matron of the Richmond Hill Home, Tricia Charles, Meryl Blake, Gillian Cruikshank, Valerie Joseph, Anne-Marie Binder, Monica McGuire, Brandon Monroe, Jocelyn Roberts, Gwyneth Andrews, Natasha Thorne, Alistair Francique, Rondell Caliste and the Bell family of Woburn and surrounding areas, the Griffith family of Woburn and Calivany, the Watson and Bain families, Dennis Henry and family, relatives and friends of Munich, Crochu, Tuileries and surrounding areas, past and present staff and students of the Woburn Methodist School, past and present members of the St. Michael's RC Church, and many other relatives and friends, too numerous to mention. The funeral service for the late Muriel Emily Bell, also known as Tanti, of Tuilleri St. Andrew, who resided at Woburn St. George, will take place on Tuesday, April 9th, commencing with tributes at 1 p.m. and service at 2 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception, Church Street, St. George's, and interment will be at the Wilberforce Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Raymond Davis Lewis, also known as Perrin, Bryna, and Uncle Davis, of Brooklyn Concord, St. John, passed away on Sunday, 17th March, 2024, at the age of 84. He was the life partner of Nordlyn Mitchell, also known as Nadju, father of Philomena, Wayne, Dexter, Roll, Raleigh, Roland, Dave, Jasmine, Jason, Morgan, Michael, and Avis. Grandfather of 30 in the USA, Canada, Grenada, and Barbados, including Shireen. Great-grandfather of 8. Father-in-law of Lenita, Rachel, Mila, Carla, Trisha, Norman, Nicole, and Marlene. Brother of George, also known as Whitebread in Grenada, Edris and Edna in Canada. Uncle of many, including Warrell, Stephanie, Mustafa, and Kenny. Many other relatives and friends in England, the USA, Canada, Barbados, Trinidad, and Grenada, including Freddie, Yvonne, Kyron, the pastor and members of the Concord Seventh-day Adventist Church, and friends and neighbors of Brooklyn, Concord, and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Raymond Davis Lewis, also known as Perrin, Bryna, and Uncle Davis, of Brooklyn, Concord, St. John, will take place on Wednesday, April 10th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Concord Seventh-day Adventist Church and entombment will be at the Power Park Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. John James Carl Harvey, also known as Metu, of Sendell Street, who resided at Rivulet Lane, Grenville, St. Andrew, passed away on Sunday, 31st March 2024, at the age of 67. He was the son of Madonna Harvey, adopted son of Clara Maureen, grandson of Gertrude Philip, brother of Joan, Sharon, Junior and Jerome in the UK, Martin Charles, Harold, Rose, Henry and Billy in the USA, uncle of Binta, Kareem, Jomo, Jamar, Marcus, Kayla and Tamika, cousin of many including Claude, Alex, Mrs. Mary Charles and family, Dr. Christine Emmons, Mrs. Mona Prince and family, Aifa, Avril, Jamel, Natasha and Naomi. Many other relatives and close friends, including DJ Francis, Mrs. Steele and staff of Grandkids Caregivers, Karen Bascom, Devonson Felix, Anne Fletcher, Brenda, Keon, Carl Hines, Elizabeth John, and friends and neighbors of Sendell Street, Rivulet Lane, Grenville, and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late John James Carl Harvey of Sendell Street, who resided at Rivulet Lane, Grenville, St. Andrew, will take place on Wednesday, April 10th at 1:30 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Grenville RC Church, and interment will be at the Grand Bra Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Peter Castle of Grand Arne St. George died on Saturday, 23rd March 2024, at the age of 63, left to mourn are his son Chad Daniel, brother Albert Castle, sister-in-law Claudia Castle, nephews Isaac and Cyrus, niece Vanessa, other relatives and friends, including the management and staff of the Event Enterprise Hotel, Buffet and the Boys on the Block, Maria Ross, the Frederick family of Willis, the Castle family of Vendham, the Francis family in London, and friends and neighbors of Montrush, Grand Arne's Valley, and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Peter Castle of Grand Arne St. George will take place on Thursday, April 11th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at Bailey's Chapel, Coronage, St. George, and interment will be at the Wilberforce Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Nettie Albert Haywood, also known as Dido, of Mount Parnassus, St. George, who resided at the Hillsview Home for the Aged Grove, passed away on Monday, 18th March 2024, at the age of 84. He was the father of Betty Sears and Delron Gibbs Haywood, brother of Cynthia, Una, Curtis, Teresa, Marina, and Jennifer, grandfather of Sahara, Phoenix, Samantha, and Chantel, great-grandfather of Far in Canada, brother-in-law of Victor Howell, Glenda Haywood, and Marie Haywood, uncle of many in Grenada and abroad, including Eunice, Sandra, Joanne, Sharon, Evis, Paula, Patricia, Catherine, Zena, and Kathy Ann. Many other close relatives and friends in Grenada, the UK, Canada, and Trinidad, including Veron, Carl, Abel, Lincoln, Leslie Ann, the Joseph and Hercules families, Claudia Simpson and family of Florida, Diana Gibbs and family of Florida, the Williams and Street families of Mount Parnassus, Ashton, David, Osbert, also known as Broco, the staff and residents of the Hillsview Home for the Aged, Guove, the staff of the National Taxi Association, and friends and neighbours of Rady, Mount Parnassus, Tempe, and Grand Mall St. George. The funeral of the late Nettie Albert Haywood, also known as Dido, of Mount Parnassus St. George, who resided at the Hillsview Home for the Aged, Guove, will take place on Friday, April 12th at 12:30 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Garden of Remembrance Funeral Chapel, Cemetery Hill, St. George's, according to Anglican rites, and interment will be at the Wilberforce Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home.
When a loved one passes on, we all need the comfort, support, and guidance of a trusted friend. You can rely on Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. We provide a personalized professional service that exceeds all expectations. Our dedicated staff responds to your every need with the greatest detail, ensuring affordability with a variety of options. Upgraded state-of-the-art facilities, spacious air-conditioned chapel with live internet streaming, a modern, environmentally safe crematorium, the only of its kind on island, private viewing spaces, large on-site repast center, a modern transportation fleet. Join our burial society today and make personalized arrangements for that final moment. As you prepare to enter your loved one into eternal rest, visit or call Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home and select a package that brings added comfort to the entire family. Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home and Burial Society, continuing a tradition of excellence.
Gloria Maureen John Hugh of Hermitage St. Patrick, who resided in Brooklyn, New York, USA, passed away on Saturday, 23rd March 2024, at the age of 61. She was the wife of Donovan Hugh, mother of Fiona, Darren, Alex, and Jamie in the USA, grandmother of Elijah, Lyric, Olivia, and Aiden, sister of Leon, Carly, and Telfer in the USA, Eunice and Raymond in Grenada, Mavis and Maria in Trinidad, and Debbie in Canada, mother-in-law of Ruby, niece of Monica John, aunt and grand-aunt of many, including Gemma, Lorraine, Chester, Curline, Keisha, Kimon, and Karen, close friend of Bethan, Bevan, Val, and Doris. Other relatives and friends in Trinidad, Canada, the USA, and Grenada, including the John, Date, and George families of Hermitage, and friends and neighbors of Hermitage and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Gloria Maureen John Hugh of Hermitage St. Patrick, who resided in Brooklyn, New York, USA, will take place on April 14th at New Haven Temple SDA Church in Brooklyn, New York, USA. Arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Irene Bartholomew, also known as Mabel Bartholomew of Granton, New Hampshire, St. George, died on Friday, 22nd March 2024. At the age of 98, left to mourn are her children, Peter Bartholomew in the USA, Eugene Bartholomew, Joseph Bartholomew, and Adrian Bartholomew. 14 grandchildren, Kanisha Slinger, Sherry Bain, Brad Bartholomew, Nixon, Nicholas and Nicole Philip, Kevon, Aisha Francis, Leandra, Leeshawn, Kenrick, Ricky, Karina, and Akita Amedi. 24 great-grandchildren, 2 great-great-grands, daughter-in-law Evelyn Bartholomew, caregiver Kalisha Bristol, Other relatives and friends, including Dr. the Right Honourable Keith Mitchell, Clementine Braveboy, Miss Ina, Catherine Frederick, the Frederick and Johnson families of New Hampshire, the Bartholomew family of New Hampshire and Vendome, and friends and neighbours of Granton in New Hampshire and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Irene Bartholomew, also known as Mabel Bartholomew of Granton, New Hampshire, St. George, will take place on Monday, April 15th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Granton Seventh-day Adventist Church, New Hampshire, and interment will be at the family cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Finbar McQueen of Pedmotaw, St. David, died on Friday, April 5th, 2024, at the age of 66. The funeral arrangements for the late Finbar McQueen of Pedmotaw, St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Bernadine Moraine, also known as Buns, of Syracuse, St. David, who resided at Mount Parnassus, St. George, passed away on Saturday, April 6th, 2024, at the age of 55. The funeral arrangements for the late Bernadine Moraine, also known as Buns, of Syracuse, St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Joseph Cuthbert Rodney Pascal, also known as Joe, of True Blue, who resided at Montu St. George, a well-known taxi operator and former employee of McIntyre Brothers Limited, passed away on Wednesday, 27th March, 2024, at the age of 52. The funeral arrangements for the late Joseph Cuthbert Rodney Pascal, also known as Joe, of True Blue, who resided at Montu St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Edward Nelson MacDonald, also known as Ricky, of Woodlands St. George, died on Wednesday, April 3rd, 2024, at the age of 62. The funeral arrangements for the late Edward Nelson MacDonald, also known as Ricky, of Woodlands St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Mary Jocelyn Phillip of Madey St. Patrick, who resided in the United Kingdom, passed away on Friday, 29th March 2024, at the age of 80. The funeral arrangements for the late Mary Jocelyn Phillip of Madey St. Patrick, who resided in the United Kingdom, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Godfrey Millett of Paraclete St. Andrew, who resided at Caliste St. George, passed away on Sunday, 31st March 2024 in the USA. The funeral arrangements for the late Godfrey Millett of Paraclete St. Andrew, who resided at Caliste St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Wayne's Funeral Services. Raphael H. Bishop of Westerhall Point, St. David, died on Monday, March 25th, 2024. The funeral arrangements for the late Raphael H. Bishop of Westerhall Point, St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. James Patrick, also known as Yeri of St. John St. Andrew, who resided in Trinidad, passed away on Sunday, 25th February 2024, at the age of 78. The funeral arrangements for the late James Patrick, also known as Yeri of St. John St. Andrew, who resided in Trinidad, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Vernessa Harford, also known as Nessie and Nessa, of St. James St. Andrew, who resided at Redgate St. David, passed away on Thursday, March 14th, 2024, at the age of 32. The funeral arrangements for the late Vernessa Harford, also known as Nessie and Nessa, of St. James St. Andrew, who resided at Redgate St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Enid Butler, also known as Auntie Enid of St. Dominic Street, Gwarf, St. John, passed away on Tuesday, March 5th, 2024, at the age of 99. The funeral arrangements for the late Enid Butler, also known as Auntie Enid of St. Dominic Street, Grove, St. John, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home.
The management and staff of MTV extend deepest condolences to those of you whose loved ones have passed on. Thank you for watching.
Hi, my name is Bishop Daniel Moore, the Bishop of Jerusalem Spiritual Baptist Church. Jesus is quoting that if you believe in him, you shall live again.